Fast, a quick warm-up this afternoon if you're lucky enough to be in an area where the clouds have already moved out.
Chief Meteorologist Tony Petracca is in the Weather Center. We were talking about this earlier. Felt a lot like summer with the humidity today, Tony.
Yeah, it's up a little bit, so it's got a little of a subtle hint of summer. And temperatures finally responding to the sunshine that's coming out right now. The warmest temp we could find at this hour, Greenville, North Scituate, northern part of the state, already approaching 70. So getting kind of this last-minute warm-up before the sun goes down. Take a look outside. It took long enough. It was about maybe 3 hours behind schedule. We were thinking the sun breaking out around 12, 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It took a little longer, but it's here, and the temperatures are nice. We're well into the 60s, and here in North Scituate, already approaching 70 degrees. It is a little cooler along the shoreline. You can see temperatures, I mean, not bad along the coast. I mean, this is above average, but not quite as mild as inland spots. Here in Providence, 66, Taunton, 67. We'll add another degree or two to these numbers, and I should do it for the high temp. The sun came out first. My earpiece fell out. Out in Connecticut. Look at Hartford right now, coming in at 75 and Willimantic at 73. So it is a warm sun. As we take a look at what we're tracking, nice and comfortable for this evening. However, I do expect the fog to return later in the evening and during the overnight. Showers by dawn. It's a very windy, warm day coming up on Friday. We may see gusts as high as 40, 50 miles per hour. Now, it's not a washout. However, watch for a passing shower or thunderstorm. So keep the umbrella nearby. You won't need it the entire day, but there will be the chance of a shower. Nothing's changed for the weekend. Still that half and half weekend with Saturday being the better day. So the clouds finally breaking apart. In the meantime, another storm making national news with an outbreak of severe weather across the southeast. This area of low pressure will track up into northern New England. What it will do for us, give us a passing shower or thunderstorm, kick up the wind, and actually reinforce some of the milder air. We won't get severe weather, but we could see an isolated thunderstorm. Meanwhile, another outbreak of tornadoes across Mississippi and Alabama as we speak right now, so severe weather is ongoing. The milder air up the eastern third of the country right now will hold on to this for a few more days before we turn cooler on Sunday. The reason for that would be clouds and some showers. Forecast this evening and overnight with clouds and fog returning, temperatures in the 50s, and here we are tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. See some of these splotches of green indicating a passing shower or a thunderstorm, and even during the afternoon, a passing shower can't be ruled out. Very mild in the 60s. Around this time tomorrow evening, we're starting to clear. Your Friday evening, Friday night looks great. You have plans to be out tomorrow night, dinner plans or whatever. The weather is fine. The temperatures are real nice as well. So here's the breakdown for Friday morning. Windy and mild. Watch for some fog early in the morning. Mostly cloudy skies. And again, watch for a passing shower or thunderstorm. There'll be a few splashes of sun tomorrow afternoon, but still keep an eye to the sky for that isolated shower or thunderstorm with temperatures that should be well into the 60s. All right, 7 day forecast. There's the half and half weekend. Saturday, clearly the better day. Make the most of it. Sunshine near 60. Looking at showers, actually rain likely on Sunday, and cooler with highs in the middle 50s, and then a cool down for early next week. Brian and Mike.